Hello everybody and welcome to this tutorial. Today I will show you how to install VirtualBox within a Windows environment. So previously I've showed you how to do it in a Linux environment, and it is a bit more complex there because you do need to add repositories and then pull the packet from the repositories. You can also pull it from the website, but that's not recommended. However, in Windows, the process is fairly straightforward. It's fairly simple. You just go ahead, open up your favorite browser. Mine is Firefox, and go ahead and type in VirtualBox. Press enter and go ahead and open up their website. Takes a bit to load. Don't know what the problem is. Perhaps my internet connection is slow. Never mind. Just click on downloads and choose VirtualBox 43224 Windows hosts. So just go ahead and click on it. And I don't want to download it now because I've downloaded it prior to this tutorial in order to save some time. But since you didn't, just go ahead and click on save file and it will download it. The download process will start. I'm just going to go ahead and navigate over to my downloads folder. I have it right here. So I'm just going to go ahead and double click on it in order to initiate the installation wizard. Keep in mind that this is actually a virtual machine, and I am conducting an installation of VirtualBox within a machine that is being run within yet another VirtualBox. So a virtual machine within a virtual machine would be a proper way to name the situation. You can see I've minimized it and I can pull it now around, but it works just fine. The installation process will go no problems. It will go fairly smoothly without any problems. So just go ahead and click next on these options. You can actually browse for a different installation location here, but the default one will do just fine. So just go ahead and click next, create shortcuts, register file association, sure, why not, click next. This warning is basically telling you that it will reset your network connection. So if you don't want that to happen, you might halt the installation process or something like that, but don't worry, even if you're downloading something, it's not a big deal. If your interfaces are reset, your connection goes down and then it comes back up again and your download might just stop for a while and that's it, continue on later. Anyway, just go ahead and click yes, install, and there we go. Oops, don't worry, it's not an error or something like that. It's just Windows asking for our permission. Anyway, the installation process has started here, no problems. And as I was talking about it previously, this is a virtual machine within a virtual machine. The installation of the program will go fine, no problems. However, if you plan to run another virtual machine within this virtual box, within this virtual machine, you might encounter some problems. So start the virtual box after installation, finish, sure, why not? And as I said, you might encounter some problems performance-wise because, I mean, you would need to have crazy good hardware in order to accomplish this feat. I believe I could do it, but to the point that the virtual OS would function, but to a very limited extent, and that's it. I don't think I could actually do any meaningful work with it. That would be quite difficult to achieve. But in any case, we have our VirtualBox manager here. Here, I'm spinning it around, and the process of creating pretty much new virtual machines is exactly the same, more or less. The options have the same places, so you'll be able to follow this tutorial through even if you are using Windows and have created a virtual machine, for the most part anyway. I'm just gonna go ahead and close it now. I will uninstall it here because it's completely pointless for the time being. But in any case, I hope that this was helpful to all the Windows users out there, because let's face it, a lot of people do use Windows. However, for pen testing purposes, for ethical hacking, Windows is not the best operating system to use out there, primarily because it's a lot harder to become anonymous with Windows, to anonymize yourself, and furthermore, most of the pen testing hacking tools were actually designed for Unix, Linux-like environments to work in combination with their terminals. However, the choice of the operating system is completely up to you. I will be working with Fedora, Linux, and I will most likely be using this Windows machine as some sort of a victim which we will be attacking and exploiting. Anyway, I bid you all farewell, and I hope to see you in the next tutorial.